गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम टेलिंग टू यू व्हाट आर द एविडेंसेस इन सपोर्ट ऑफ लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन। सो हाउ वी कैन से दैट इज लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन एग्जिस्ट। सो फॉर दैट नाउ, बिकॉज नंबर फर्स्ट ऑब्जर्वेशन, रोटेशन ऑफ अर्थ अराउंड द सन और दैट ऑफ मून अराउंड द अर्थ इज एक्सप्लेन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस लॉ ओनली। टाइड्स आर फॉर्म्ड। The times of solar and lunar eclipse can be calculated on the basis of this law. The orbit and periodic revolution of artificial satellite can be determined on the basis of this only. The value of small g varies place to place also can be explained on the basis of Newton's gravitational law. Next is vector form of the law of gravitation. What are the vector form? You know, vector means direction. So you can see, suppose there are two particles m1 and m2. I told you that m1 is applying force on m2 towards this attractive force, and m2 is applying force on m1 towards m2. So that is called force applied on first particle by second mass, and this is force applied on second particle by the first mass. R12, that is distance from A to B, and this is distance from B to A, R to A, vector distance, unit vector. This is unit vector and this is vector shown to you. He is saying the value of force applied on 1 by 2 is this negative sign, and force applied by 2 by 1 is minus this. But you know, R21 is equal to negative of R12. So that's why I can write in place of this. So I can write F21 is equal to minus F12. It means negative sign is showing the direction. So direction of force are always opposite. So we say each action has equal and opposite reaction. So next is principle of superposition of gravitational force. What does the superposition principle says? Suppose there are 3-4 masses. 1, 2, 3, 4 masses. So that is mass 2, mass 3 and mass 4 is applying force on mass m1. So he is saying m2 is applying force on m1, m3 is applying force on m1, m4 is also applying force on m1. So direction you can check: force applied on 1 by 4, force applied on 1 by 3, force applied on 1 by 2. So what will be the total force applied on m1? So he is saying it is the vector sum of the individual force applied on particle 1. So this is only said superposition principle. The important inference is the presence of the force applied on 1 by 2 is independent of the presence of m3 and m4. So whether they are present or not, so it will remain independent. F12 will remain independent of that. F14 will remain independent of the concept that mass m2 and mass m3 is present here. So this is only called principle of superposition in the gravitational law. So by the principle of superposition, the total gravitational force on m1 is vector sum of force on mass m1 by 2 by 3 by 4. So I will add them all together. So this is all about the cell theorem. That is nothing. Cell theorem, you know, that is empty ball like cell theorem. Understood? A point mass is lies outside the uniformly spherical cell. A spherical symmetrical internal mass distribution. The spherical cell attract the point mass as if the entire mass is present at the center of the spherical cell. So this is called cell theorem. And second point of the cell theorem is, if a point lies inside the uniform spherical cell, the gravitational force on the point mass is zero. So on that point mass, there will be no gravitational force. So that's all about the gravitational or cell theorem. And gravitational shielding possible. Shielding means, can the gravitational force be protected? Understood? So same way, if cell does not shield the bodies outside it from the entering the gravitational force on the particle lying inside it, thus the gravitational force shielding is not possible, though the shielding is possible in electrostatic force. So that's all for today. Have a great time. Thank you.